Okay. Let's talk for a couple of minutes about something that's dear to my heart. Let's talk about the Internet Archive. I stumbled into the Internet Archive about 5 or 6 years ago. I should note that the Internet Archive is affiliated with the Library of Congress. It's a vast storage place for all sorts of knowledge, books, music, all sorts of things, old and new. A lot of people are posting new materials in there. It's a totally different place from YouTube and the social sites in that it's really meant to be a library or an archive. A couple of years ago, and start out from my point of view, okay? A couple of years ago, I was into video editing about 5 years with digital equipment done on home computers and had got to be the point where I was fairly competent with it and kind of had gained some sort of reputation locally for doing video editing. I had people coming to me and asking me questions about video editing, and I had a tendency to say, you know, just do this and do that, and it never failed that the people would look at me and say, well, I don't have any footage like that to do that kind of editing. All I have is my little camera and I haven't had a chance to film those kind of things yet. What can I do in the meantime to work on things like this? Well, I had gone out and looked for the Internet Archive, looking for places where I could find footage for them that they could just go and download, so that when I would be talking to them on the phone, I could say, just go here and download footage from here and do what you want. Well, I found the Internet Archive. And it's a tremendous place for getting stock footage. You have to use some caution. You have to be aware that you want to use public domain materials. You want to be careful not to trample on other people's rights and stuff. And you have to be aware that occasionally somebody posts stuff in there that is not out of copyright. And so you have to use a little bit of caution, but usually they're pretty good about taking down material that's not. And it came down to me that I wanted someplace safe that I could send these people to, that they could get footage and I wouldn't have to worry about whether they were going to get in trouble for copyright or so on and so forth. And the only way I had been able to figure out how to do it up to that point was I would burn a DVD and I was just handing them out saying, here, go take this, load it on your computer, and when we talk about editing, we'll have something in common to talk about and to deal with. Well, in the process of this, I had found the Internet Archive, and I decided what I was going to do was I was going to take 10 standard clips from Florida. Things like, you know, alligators and, you know, sunsets and beaches and stuff, and things that are standard Florida that a person in the mountains wouldn't be able to easily get a hold of. And I was going to take footage filmed on a GL1 or a GL2, Canon GL1 or GL2, and post it for free for people to use. So I did up a little package of 10 of these, and I posted them in the Internet Archive. About a week or so went by, and I got a letter, an email, from the Internet Archive. And they said that if I would post 40 more clips, that they would set up an individual place for stock footage, free stock footage for people to use, and basically it would give people a chance to be able to post footage from all around the world for people to be able to use for free as stock footage. But you had to post it within the public domain to a degree. You couldn't, you know, make any money off of it or anything. It was a non-profit and everything was posted for people to use for free. So I posted 40 more clips. I'd filmed for years and was always filming scenes of nature, sunsets, sunrises, just all sorts of stuff. It was really easy to come up with 40 or 50 one-minute clips that could be used for free stock footage. And I kind of got to liking it. And when we hit the 50, sure enough, there was a separate section set aside for free stock footage. And I could send the people there and just let them load the footage right off the internet, the actual AVs that I had shot with the cameras. And it was really cool, and I had a lot of fun with it. So afterwards, there were a couple other people that started to donate their time, and I found that I would go through every weekend and go through a couple of my tapes that I had recorded over the years, and I would lift stock footage that I had created for other projects and so on and so forth. And about every weekend, for about a year or so, I posted free stock footage, 10 clips at a time, in the archive. So I posted hundreds of clips, a lot of stuff. Let's just say probably more than 500, in about a one-year period. It was easy to do. It wasn't like it was a strain or a job or anything like that. And several other photographers posted free stock footage from use from around the world. And it turned into quite a resource. And frankly, it's kind of amazed me how it's grown and stuff. It's one of those things that you start out and you really have no concept where it's going to grow to be. At this point, my videos alone have ranked hundreds of thousands, if not millions, of hits. It's been a real learning experience for me. I've had people from all around the world write me and talk to me about it and stuff, and heads of PBS stations and professors in colleges and stuff have contacted me and talked to me. And it all just started out as doing something nice for somebody, and it was really simple. And I suppose if I was going somewhere with all this, number one, it would be volunteerism. I know you're going to hate that. Volunteerism is a really cool thing. I mean, you'd be amazed what you can do with volunteerism. And I want to say that I think it's reflective of a new society, that things on the internet are being made available. I think up till now there's been a lot of emphasis on copyright issues and problems, and that people are using copyrighted materials and that it's getting them in trouble. Well, I think part of that problem is that they aren't aware that there are materials out there that they could use that wouldn't get them in trouble or shouldn't get them in trouble. There is music on the internet that has been developed that is specifically designed to be able to be of use in your videos and not get you in any trouble. And there are videos out there that are specifically designed for you to be able to use for free. I feel like it's important, if you're going to do that, that you should emphasize that people have these free resources. One last little thing I want to say about the whole Internet Archive experience. From time to time, people contact me and ask me various questions about use of the stock footage and use of just plain downloading from the Internet Archive. I don't work for the archive or anything. I'm just a guy who posted a bunch of footage that people use for free. But recently, I had a student contact me, and I want to note here that, you know, out of these hundreds of videos I posted, they were like all sorts of nature footage that I thought people might enjoy. They were wild pigs and wild turkey and butterflies and alligators and snakes and assorted birds and sunsets and sunrises. And I mean, it was Florida. It's a paradise. Everything here is beautiful. How could you not film things that were really cool? And I put a lot of silly footage in there too for kids to use in their videos and stuff. But basically, it was a lot of really neat stuff. But what I was really shocked to find is, after I'd posted all this footage, that there were two things that have got the most hits. And these are, at the winners at this time are, film countdowns. And yes, I literally mean the film countdown that you use in the front of a film. And TV static. Yeah, that's right, actually tuned to station so that there was no station there, filmed the static and posted it. They're both in the range of 40, 50,000 hits a couple years in now. And at one point I had a student contact me and say that she was using it for a film project but she couldn't get it to download. She was using a Mac and she couldn't figure out how to get it to download. And finally, between the two of us, we figured it out. And but the point of this was that in this conversation, she told me she was going to download the film countdown. And I said, well, I'm really pleased, but you're going through so much trouble to be able to download this. Why are you going so much trouble for a film countdown? Because the lady was really working hard trying to get this. And she said, I'm a student, and I really need this for my film project. And if you hadn't posted it, I don't know what I'd have done. And I said, well, you could get you could get film countdowns cheap. And I said, she said, no, you don't understand what they charge for film countdowns and the rights to them. And I was kind of shocked when they told me. And even when she said, oh, they give us a student discount, the price they charged was, to me, rather steep. Now, I realize it's a business for them and stuff, but, and I don't know, perhaps their countdowns look more professional, so on and so forth, but for this girl, it made the difference between being able to do her film project or not. And it was a nice feeling knowing that she was able to use that footage in the end and that it saved her that money and stuff. They're students, and I feel like they need the help, all the help they can get, God knows, at this time. At the time when I was talking to the girl, I said, you know, I made these up in an hour or two. It's not like they were a complicated, difficult thing to do. And she said, no, you don't understand. I'm a student. I don't have an hour or two to spare. Every minute is important to me. And so at that point, I began to realize that this footage had kind of gone beyond me and was getting a lot of good for people. In the midst of all this, most of the people who posted their footage within the free stock footage section had posted it as plain public domain. I put one little caveat on mine. I asked for attribution. And what that means is I asked for them to tell when they used my footage. Well, I did this because I just wanted to know where was the footage going. I always felt like I gave it away. It's not mine to control or anything, but I was just curious to know. So it never came down to I was going to enforce any sort of a copyright or anything. This was all about, I just wanted to be able to see where the stuff went. And it began to spread like ripples in a pool. And it went to be about, oh God, I don't know. After it hit 100 or 150 videos that had used the footage, I began to realize this was growing in an exponential manner. In other words, the students in the schools who picked it up, and it was getting way beyond me. So at this point, I am tracking, I have a video, or not a video, I have a YouTube site that I call the Stock Footage Channel. And I'll put a link to it in the description with this video. It's not about my videos, although I guess in a way it is, in a small way. It's about people on YouTube in particular who have used one of my little bits of stock footage and just simply recognized me for it. And there's a lot of them. And I have to say, some of them are, in my opinion, extremely good. People took some simple little snippet and either made fun of it or used it in a music video or did something with it that I was very impressed with. Of course, there's a lot of silly stuff, a lot of play, you know, students having fun and so on and so forth, but some very impressive stuff in there. So this comes down to, it's been a real learning experience for me, and I repeat, I don't mean to offend anybody or say anything unnatural, but volunteerism can be a very cool thing. And I've volunteered a lot in my life. Don't get me wrong, this isn't the first time, and it wasn't like I just did something and it got a little out of control, but it's been nice. It's been nice to do something simple that has helped so many people, and it's been nice to feel like something has been improved in the world by something I did. It's a good feeling. You know what I mean? Didn't put any money in my pocket, but it was worth it. A little bit of time. And still growing. Yeah, so anyway, point being, I'll put a link in the thing for the stock footage section in the Internet Archive, and I'll put a link in the description talking about where the stock footage channel is I have on YouTube, where it's basically a salute to the YouTube users that have used my simple little clips in some small way. It may only be 10 seconds out of their whole video, but they acknowledged the use of it and stuff, and I think they deserve a little acknowledgement themselves. So if you get a chance, go over and go see the videos that they've created with some free stock footage. Okay, enough for now. I'm going to shut this off right now. Talk to y'all later. Bye.